Netherton Park used to have a junior school and an infant school, so they made it into a primary and shut the infants down. Well, the local residents group broke in and took over the infant school for 2 weeks, and they slept and they ate with the children in the old community centre, just to prove to the council that that there was a need for support for the families on the estate.
When did Netherton Park Community Centre first start?
It started by the Park Lane residents group in 1985. They moved into the centre in 1987.
What was the purpose of that?
There was a need for the children and young people to have somewhere to go, local residents to go and have somewhere to meet together, to socialise, talk to people and get support and help, because the estate is quite isolated by major busy roads, and there's lots of industries surrounding the estate, and the buses, they don't come too often, and not many people had cars then.
What was your childhood like?
Well, I grew up in Bootle Village. I was one of 13 children. I was number 12, and my mum used to say that she had to put some of us in drawers to sleep because she couldn't afford cots, and we were in a two up and two down. And then she got the next door house. My dad put a hole going through it, which made it four bedrooms, but we had no bathroom and we had a toilet outside. My mum couldn't afford a midwife when she was having me, so she didn't know when she was due. My gran would deliver me in the living room, which was like many people then. A lot of babies were born at home. We grew up in the streets of Bootle Village, in cobble streets, and there was a lot of demolished properties. And the houses we lived in were must have been built in the beginning of the century, because they were just really basic. Just a living room coming in from the doorstep from the street, and a kitchen, and as I say, a yard with a toilet in. And then we moved to Netherton, where we had a front garden, a large back garden, a bathroom, a toilet downstairs, four bedrooms. You know, there was lots of space. It was parks.
But the school's not there no more?
No, the school was closed because the population dropped. The estate was mainly masonettes, and the council decided to demolish the masonettes and build houses. The numbers of the school then dropped dramatically, so they had to shut part of the school, which was the infants, but it was also a community centre. So we fought and we kept the community centre and got a brand new building built. We support disabled children, young people and young adults and their carers. We have play schemes, we have youth projects, Fun for Kids After School Club, so we have a cafe, we are now even setting up our own nursery, and we support the local community with their education, so we're still a crucial part of the community.
We've heard there's many reasons why the estate's called dodgy. What do you think the reason is?
The main one that sticks out my mind is that people used to dodge the rent collector when he used to come round to collect the rent money. And that's why it's called dodge.
Thanks for the interview.
You're welcome.